Hello everyone, this is Ruchi Kulkarni and today we are going to do The Snake Drawing, which is a poem written by W.W.E. Ross and it is taken from your book Beehive of class 9th. What would be your first reaction on spotting a snake? Of course you'll attempt to kill it, isn't it? Humans have a notion that snakes are dangerous and try to kill them as soon as they spot one. But this is not true. Though snakes are creations of nature, we are afraid of them. In the poem, The Snake Drawing, its poet W.W.E. Ross shows the snake as a victim and man as the assailant. You'll understand this when we read the poem. So in this session, we'll understand the poem with its poetic devices, significance of the title, message given by it, and end the session with summary and question answers. But first, something about the poet W.W.E. Ross. William Wrightson Eustace Ross was born on 14 June 1894, Peterborough, Canada. He was a Canadian geophysicist and poet. He was the first published poet in Canada to write imagist poetry and later the first to write surrealist verse, both of which have led some to call him the first modern Canadian poet. Ross' passion for the natural world is evident in his poetry through its focus on Canada's physical environment. He published only two collections during his lifetime, Laconics in 1930 and Sonnets in 1932. After 1930, the majority of Ross' work was published in anthologies and literary magazines at the behest of editors. He died on 26th August 1966 in Toronto, Canada. The snake, trying to escape the pursuing stick with sudden curvings of thin, long body. How beautiful and graceful are his shapes. He glides through the water away from the stroke. Oh, let him go over the water into the reeds to hide without hurt. Small and green, he is harmless even to children. Along the sand, he lay until observed and chased away. And now he vanishes in the ripples among the green, slim reeds. The snake, trying to escape the pursuing stick with sudden curvings of thin, long body. This poem starts with the scenario that a person is hitting a snake and this snake is trying to escape. It is trying to run away that stroke of stick. Pursuing means chasing, and pursuing stick here refers to a person who is chasing the snake with a stick. And while the snake is trying to escape or move away from that place to protect itself, it does it with sudden curvings of its thin, long body. The snake has a thin, long body, and while moving, it curves its body. We all know that. So in the attempt to escape, the snake's body moves in curves and the snake is trying to escape that stick with which the person is chasing or with which the person is trying to hit it. How beautiful and graceful are his shapes. And the way the snake is moving, the poet finds it very graceful. The poet finds the snake's movement very beautiful and graceful because as it moves in curves and it creates beautiful shapes. So through these lines, the poet is trying to tell us that the snake is escaping from being hit by the stick. And as the snake crawls, its body twists and turns, forming beautiful and fascinating shapes. He glides through the water away from the stroke. Glides means moves. So the snake is moving through the water. He's now in the water and he's trying to move away from the stroke. Stroke is the hitting of the stick. He's trying to protect himself from being hit by that stick. Oh, let him go over the water into the reeds to hide without hurt. The poet here is requesting the person who is chasing. He is requesting to let the snake go. To let the snake go over the water into the reeds. Reeds are the water plants which have thick stem. And when the snake will reach the reeds into the water, he can hide himself without getting hurt. Small and green, he is harmless even to children. The poet here tells the speciality of this particular snake. This snake is small in size and green in color. And often small and green colored snakes are harmless. They do not bite. They are not poisonous. And they are harmless even to children. Therefore, through these lines, the poet is trying to explain that besides being beautiful and graceful, the snake is also harmless. It is green in color, small in size, but it is not poisonous. Then why should one hit it or why should one hurt that snake? So the poet is requesting to let the snake go, to let it protect itself and hide in the reeds which are grown in water. Along the sand he lay until observed and chased away. Till now the snake was quiet in the sand. He lay until it was observed. Till it was spotted and chased away by the person holding a stick. It lay quietly in the sand. And now he vanishes in the ripples among the green slim reeds. Till the time it was spotted, it lay quietly. But now, in order to save itself, the snake disappears. It vanishes and it goes in the ripples. Ripples means waves of the water. It goes and disappears itself in the water and hides in the green bushes of those slim reeds. Reeds are the plants which are grown in water. So it, since the color of the snake is also green, when it goes in those watery plants, it camouflages itself or it matches the background of the plants so that it can hide itself, protect itself, and cannot be seen by the chaser. These last lines of the poem make us understand that how afraid the snake was. The snake in this poem is portrayed as a victim, and the person who is hitting it with a stick is portrayed as an assailant. So we must understand that not all snakes can bite us. Some are harmless, some are even afraid and fearful of human beings, because it is we human beings who actually harm them without any provocation. After this explanation of the poem, we now move on to the poetic devices used here. The first poetic device is alliteration, which is repetition of initial consonant sounds of two or more consecutive words. The line, he is harmless, has got alliteration where her sound is repeated. Imagery is a poetic device wherein the author uses words or phrases that appeal to any of the senses or any combination of senses to create mental images for the reader. So imagery helps the reader to visualize more realistically the author's writings. The following are the lines can be examples of imagery. With sudden curvings of thin long body, he glides through the water away from the stroke. He vanishes in the ripples among the green slim reeds and many other sentences. The next poetic device is transferred epithet. It is an adjective that qualifies a noun. In the poem, the word pursuing stick refers to the person who is holding the stick and is determined to kill the snake. Thus, the example of transferred epithet is pursuing stick in this poem. The next poetic device is personification, which is an attribution of human characteristics to animals and non-living things. For example, in the poem, the poet refers the snake using the pronoun he, which is used for humans. Thus, here, the snake is personified. Rhyme scheme is a rhyming pattern which is formed at the end of each line of a poem or a verse. This particular poem has no proper rhyme scheme, and therefore it can be called as a free verse. The title reveals that the snake is making an effort. This title is repeated in the opening line to reinforce the trying by the snake. It makes the reader curious and he reads the rest of the poem to learn that the snake is a victim and is trying to save himself from someone who is chasing him in order to kill him with a stick. Thus, the title is apt as it initiates the curiosity of the reader and prompts him to find out about the snake's efforts. In this poem, the poet tries to say that human beings react to snakes based on their own fears. He points out that not all snakes are poisonous. In fact, some of them are quite harmless. It is cruel to attack a snake as soon as we see it. Even if a snake is poisonous, it'll do us no harm if it doesn't see any danger from us, because a snake only bites in self-protection. And otherwise, it is as harmless as any other creature. But sadly, human beings are the ones who attack a snake without provocation. Thus, we need a change in our attitude towards these graceful creatures of nature. That's all in the session. Stay till end for the summary and question answers related to this poem. I'll see you again in my next video with a new topic. Till then, take good care of yourself and stay blessed. Goodbye.